Yeah.
Oh, you got it? All
that'll slide out of that, and then that should go under the pump. You had to go up and get that. So that's why we have to catch it. So you just put it right here. Okay.
You see
the
side cap?
Yeah, that's your side cap. All this right here, this your cap too. So this right here, this your cap pull, this your cap pull. So what you're going to do, you're going to get it. So let's roll it back to the point where you feel like you can get it up in there. That should be right there. Stick it in there. So what you're going to do is you're going to twist this first.
Yes.
Now you're going to twist this first. You're going to twist like,
this part right here?
Yeah. Get up in there as much as you can and twist it in. Just this part first. Let's see. You might have another one. That one first. Is it catching it? Ain't catching it? Might need it. Try. Sometimes that'll happen in the field where that bitch won't catch.
That's
okay. Because that's what's happening is this right here, when you're twisting it down, that's what's going to be pulling that shit out at the same time.
Okay.
Yeah. And you're going to feel it because it's going to get harder.
Which way is this supposed to go?
That's just so it can catch it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, now you got to put your hands on it, look. Because it's going to come out.
Left it loose?
Keep twisting.
Oh, yeah.
But it's going to pull it out as it twists.
I see.
Yeah.
Boom. And what this tool called right here?
This your cap pull.
Cap pull.
Yes, sir, huh? So in the field, usually you'll just put it like you have your little cage, you put it down.
Yeah.
And then just untwist it.
What you said that I just pulled up?
That's your cap you just pulled up.
Okay. Yeah, that's kind of sense though.
Yeah. So just untwist that bit, and I'm gonna tell you what to look for on your cap. So this D ring right here. When you pull out a cap, most people don't pay attention to this, but you gotta make sure this shit is straight. Like if it has any like dents or marks or curls on that bitch, take that bitch out, change it out. You know what I'm saying? Get a new one. But this one good. Another thing to look for is when you like around here, this area right here. Just look for like sometimes when you do pound, because you're gonna have to pound this back in when you're in the field. Sometimes when you pound it, it leaves marks and scratches and shit like that on here. Some people don't look for it, but I like to look for it just to the pump will fuck up. You know what I'm saying? If you got marks and scratches and you know what I'm saying, cuts and shit like that on there.
That would have to like report it or something?
Yeah. Alright. So now we got that up. We're gonna have to take the top out. Okay. Yeah, so. So you want to hit it that way so you have to get it loose.
This way to get it loose?
That way.
This way to get it loose?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, left it loose the right time.
Yeah.
Right,
I got you. Top.
Right.
This is strictly for the side, so you make sure you remember what you want. Okay. Cool. So now we got a kettle up here. So you gotta get your kettle lid here. Sometimes I ain't gonna lie, it's gonna be some of them gonna be like stuck just because of the sand and all that water in that sand.
Yeah.
It's always gonna be, it's gonna be contested up, so you gotta shake that bit sometimes. You're gonna have to put your arm. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm gonna show you the difference between this side, that cap, and this cap. So you gonna
all,
so you gonna know the difference in the caps. Because the tops always gonna have a nipple. So you wanna know if they got a nipple, it's gonna go on your top. You see those they got no nipple. You wanna know if it's going to your side.
That's
alright. So now, you got the spring. And then this is your valve right here. This should be a mag right there, that mag right there.
You got
a
mag?
That's right though. You see? This is technically, you feel how to feel this, good valve. So what you're looking for is like the grooves of these will be dented in. You know what I'm saying? Like they have a big ass space, big ass gap. Sometimes this whole thing will be ripped off. So you see the yellow piece?
Yeah.
Sometimes that whole yellow piece will be ripped off. Sometimes some of the grooves of the yellow piece will be ripped off. That's what you're looking for, to see if it's a bad valve. All
right.
And then now this is your seat right here.
Yeah.
Now you can feel it, like if you take your glove off, you can feel like it's smooth. So usually a bad seat will be like rusty, you know, marked up like this right here. And like you'll have like, you see how this, like you just, they have a dip in the groove, you know what I'm saying? Like this won't be so smooth, they have a dip in it, you know what I'm saying? That's how you gonna know.
We gonna have all our changes to like equipment right outside?
Yeah, you'll have to go get your equipment.
Oh,
then
okay.
Bring it to the pump. You feel me? So next thing you're gonna do, you see this one. They over here, they call it a longhorn.
Yeah, longhorn.
To get your longhorn out, it's two ways. One, if you're out in that field, sometimes like deep, they kind of hard. But if you want to, you can just use your hand to twist it out. But they want you to use the T. This is your T hand. Yeah, I think this is called your T bar. This is your T bar right here. So if you do,
take it from the top.
Yeah, you get it from the top. Put it in there like that. You twist it. You're going to push down and twist.
Oh, all right.
Take that out, and just like that, you always gotta have a spring. The spring, and then just make sure that, because you know the plunger is gonna be kicking back and forth. So this right here, when you pull it down and push it out to the spring, it just make sure that it's not hitting. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like the plunger ain't hitting this. Like if you would just put it in like that, when I push it down, the plunger gonna knock that shit out.
Yeah.
It's gonna fuck up the pump. So you gotta push that bit down so the plunger can have somewhere to go to go in and out. Because when you pumping, your valve is going up and down, and all that water and all that sand, it's soaking it up. It's going up and down, it's soaking it up. So that's why you gotta make sure that you're secure. You feel me? Because you don't want your valve to pop up. You know what I'm saying? So what a magnet.
The seat.
Yeah, just take the other valve off. Just try that out.
Got that
toy. Yeah. Yeah, I like to use This part, you gotta push down and twist, and it's gotta be parallel like that.
So you push down and twist?
Yeah, push down and twist. You got it, because it's the grooves. It's the grooves down there. It's gonna catch onto the grooves. Down, start twisting. Push as hard as you can and twist. Look at that shit.
Yeah. Oh, I see the groove too.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, you can see it. Like, you can see it. Yeah, make sure you just push and twist. Baby. Put that back on the top. And what you need now?
What is spring going?
That's your spring right there. Think about it. You better put your then that one. You put your valve, then you put your spring.
I put my spring on top of it.
There you go. Better to use this to put it on, or like use like a little bar or something. Cause if you don't put it on right, the spring will move. Cause you gonna have to hammer that bitch in, and the spring will move, and the spring will get caught out of place.
So that's how I would take it out. Best to take it out and put it in with that.
Yeah, but I mean, you could have did it with that. I would have rather you did it with that. Cause you already put it straight in. Cause some people, cause it's harder for you to come in and do this. You don't know. For me. You just don't want the spring to move. So I'll take it out. I'll take it They want you to use the little twisting thing.
Yeah.
But out in the field, for me, it's always been easier if I just hammer it down.
Oh, you just want to hammer it?
Yeah, because this ain't secure, my boy.
Nah, I'm talking about, you ain't want to use that?
Nah.
Just hammer it in?
Nah, no, I'm talking about they want you to use this one.
This right here.
To push it down. You got to push it down so you can seal it.
Yeah.
But me, I'd rather just hammer it in. Yeah, hit that bitch. You gonna know when it's filled in, but you gonna hear it. You know? There it is. That's how you know it's filled in. Sometimes it's it. Sometimes it's not. You can just, go around and make sure. There you go. Put the top on. Thank you. with the hammer. Get that bitch a little wet. Another thing is, you ain't gonna have all this room when you're in the field. Yeah. You're gonna be on this little ass space like this. So what you're gonna have to do is adjust to where you get swinging. You feel me? Boom. And then one more thing is, sometimes like you'll think it be tight, but it won't. So give it a tap on the top, and then since then hit it. Now hit on the side. And that'll let you know if it's really tight for real. Make sure that shit real tight and sealed, so you try to get that what you're good at. Yeah. You don't want to do it. You want to get that to the top and then hit it just to make sure that it's sealed in. That's how you know that shit, man. That shit's great. Shit, that's how you do your pump, man. That's how you take out your feet to your valve and check them out and shit like that.
Yeah. Sweet. That's what I like, bro. I appreciate that, bro.
I got it, man. Look, man.